Hello everyone. I'm going to make a quick video here simply because I like these guys. You know, I'm not saying everything they say is right or anything, but usually they do really good research, background research into just about everything they post, and right or wrong, they're just nice people and I like them. And so I was just totally shocked today when we got into watching this program and they started talking about Ghislane Maxwell and shared Timothy's story, Timothy Charles Holmseth's story. We've got to get the message to these young men so that they don't get dragged into this stuff, and so that they know what they're dealing with this criminal faction, and especially Timothy Charles Holmseth. So if I'm going to put the link to this video, which was their last one, it's Edge of Wonder, and if you'll just go over there and post and let them know that, you know, that they're dealing with a real fraud here, a grifter, a whole group of them when they're connected to Timothy. Thank you.
You go over a couple of things before we so the Ghislane Maxwell thing you wanted to talk
about.
Yeah,
let's just talk about this. So this is really fascinating. There's this guy called I just lost his name. Timothy Charles Holmseth. Supposedly he works for the Pentagon
Pedophile Task Force.
And Tyler actually interviewed one of the women who is kind of working and doing all the research related to this. What's her name, Tyler?
Nyla Nguyen. Yeah.
Okay. So this is really fascinating. According to this guy, he says that Maxwell, Ghislane Maxwell, had a secret husband who was a UFO. Who's a UFO? Who's a CEO of a worldwide shipping human trafficking company? Sorry, we're like laughing, but this is kind of serious. So yeah, no, he actually supposedly this husband of hers is this ship. He's the CEO of a shipping company, and they're trafficking humans.
Yeah,
especially kids. And so this is what this guy is finding out. And this is the same guy who came out a week or so ago and said that 16,000 arrests has happened.
Well, and if you think about what's the easiest way to hide something like this, right? Like cargo on a ship, I mean, would be up there. Right. I mean, think about it. Like now we have Ghislane Maxwell. She has a submarine port.
We already know she has a submarine port. It's like, yeah, who is this woman? Right?
Why, why is all of this stuff being done through water and shipment like this, right? Like there's just certain things about this that
and taking this a step further, then you add the Clinton Foundation, who started the whole artwork movement of trading artwork with different companies, and you don't have to go through the tariffs and you don't have to go through all the customs and everything else because it's like considered artwork. And what they're finding out was like, oh, this is a really, so you can use live artwork.
Yeah, right.
Right.
Yeah.
And then you can ship anything, what containers.
Yeah. And what can't be considered artwork now that modern art is so effed up. Right?
Exactly. Yeah. So all of this, you know, I think what's going to, you know, we're already like, people are already pulling at this thread. And I think as they keep pulling on it, it's just like, oh my gosh, all of this stuff is going to be tied together.
Okay. So this is under top 10 Weird News, Edge of Wonder Live, number 67. It's had close to 40,000 views already. And Ghislane Maxwell's secret husband revealed. That's from Timothy. So these guys have close to 500,000 subscribers. And I don't want to see them get caught up in Timothy's crap. It's at right here, 5012, Ghislane Maxwell's secret husband, and they put a question mark. They've never heard of Timothy before. So, and then down here in the where they give the links, they've got Ghislane Maxwell's secret husband, TimothyCharlesHolmseth.com. This makes me want to vomit. Okay, this is his article here. Ghislane Maxwell's secret husband is CEO of worldwide shipping human trafficking company, July 18, 2020, Timothy Holmseth. He co-founded the Boston-based company in 2010. I mean, it just shows a picture. It doesn't say who. I mean, I can't see anybody here. Evidence. Ghislane Maxwell's secret husband is human trafficking with cargo ships using technology at a scale never before seen in the history of mankind. Who Scott Borgensen is, the tech CEO with ties to Ghislane. News outlets across the world are reporting Jeffrey Epstein's child procuring Madam Ghislane Maxwell is married to a man named Scott Borgensen. Scott Borgensen, the CEO of a tech company called Cargometrics, has been tied since last year to Jeffrey Epstein's alleged Madam Ghislane Maxwell, who authorities arrested in early July, Business Insider reported. Scott Borgensen, the CEO of a maritime analytics company, is back in the news for his ties to Jeffrey Epstein's inner circle, Business Insider reported. On March 14, 2020, Cargometrics published the following, a peek inside Cargometrics' bid to build the NSA of global trade. So, I'm not going to read all of this, but I mean, I don't know if that part's true or not. He could have just got this article from somewhere else. But then he goes in here and says, the Pentagon Pedophile Task Force, which does not exist, never has existed, ever. It's a fraud and a scam. Working under Joint Special Operations Command, discovered actionable evidence turned over to the Department of Defense that showed the coordination of worldwide human trafficking has been expanded to massive database that includes every conceivable factor of human life, e.g. bloodline, DNA, genetics, including medical records. All I know is that you can't believe one single word that Timothy Holmseth says because he's a fraud. He's a criminal. I'm sorry, I'm just really sick of him. And then seeing him and his stuff pop up in Turkey, all over the place, and now with these nice guys. And there's something else here. It says Anubis symbolism found in COVID testing site. And so I went to there because I had seen that on another channel, saying that the symbol that they had inside their COVID, the O on COVID, was the Anubis from ancient Egypt. So let's go over there and I'm going to show you what it is. All right, I clicked on that link in their thing and it took me here. So I went over here and I looked up Aardvark Retools patented truck. And it came up with this. Aardvark retools patented trucks for mobile health testing. When I looked at it, and I told my husband, I said, it looks like an anteater. It doesn't look like incubus. Incubus had sharp horns and a long, pointy snout. And I said, this one looks more like an anteater. I mean, I said, you can see his little legs and everything. So, you know, they've got a big company, and I'll go over there. Hold on. Okay, this is Philadelphia Business Journal. Kansho Hawken experimental event company converts patented trucks into mobile COVID-19 testing centers. Now, you know, you guys all know how I feel about this COVID crap. You know, I've done videos on it, so I'm not going to go into that. But, you know, truth is truth. Okay, you look at this, and it says COVID mobile testing facility. And then you've got this little guy right here. I'm going to make it bigger here in just a minute so you can see it. But, and it's supposed to be the annubus, and it's this thing right here. See, he's got tall, pointy ears, and he's got a long, pointy nose. And he's supposed to be some kind of a demon god. For thousands of years, ancient Egyptians worshipped the jackal-headed god known as Anubis. He was originally venerated as the god of the dead. I've studied all this stuff, and I'm not trying to sound like a know-it-all, because the more I learn, the less I know. That's what I'm finding out. But, I mean, I can read some Sumerian. I have studied it for 20 years. So the Anubis, who knows? Who knows what it really is? You know, sometimes you got to have some common sense. But, you know, they're saying that, Kanye West is the new Anubis figure and all this stuff. So anyway, I need to find a frontal view of him so you can see what he looks like. Okay, I found one here. This is, you know, he's got these two horns, and he's got this face. So you can kind of see there. He's got from the side, he's got a really long pointed nose. So go back to the aardvark now. Okay, here's what an aardvark looks like. You see his little short stubby legs here. He's got like a snout, kind of looks like a pig. And he's got those long ears. And I'll see if I can find another. And here's Willie the aardvark. You can see he's got the little short legs and the long snout. I think they're a relative of the anteater. Okay, here's a pretty good picture of a front view of one with the long ears and the little short stubby feet. So here's the Anubis. You know, it's got there's lots of depictions of it, but here's the one we were looking at. You know, and I could see where somebody might think that's what it was. But yeah. The name of the company is Aardvark, not Anubis. So we just have to be so careful. I'm just finding out you cannot believe anything you hear and most of what you think you're seeing with your own eyes. Okay, there's a real live aardvark right there. Okay, this is, see his ears, his little squared off jaw, and his little legs. You can see his feet right there. This is an aardvark. Okay, made a little bit bigger. But see, you can see there's his little feet. That's his shoulders. And he's walking face frontwards. That's what, when I looked at it, I thought, kind of looks like an anteater. But I wasn't thinking about the aardvark. So there's that. And there's the real life aardvark. And there's the aardvark that they put inside the O of COVID. Because this company is called the Aardvark Trucking Company. And there's the anubis. I don't think it's the same thing. So there you go. So, like I said, most of you know how I feel about the COVID-19 stuff and the mask and all that, and the testing centers and all that stuff. But reality is reality. That's an aardvark, not an anubis. Thank you.
When I walk on by, girls be looking like Debbie Fly. I pick to the beat, walking down the street in my new the freak, yeah. This is how I roll, animal print pants out control. It's Red Bull with the big ass bra, and like Bruce Lee, I got the clout, yeah.
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body.
I work out.
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body.
I work out. When I walk in the spot, this is what I see. Everybody stops and is staring at me. I got passion in my pants and I ain't afraid to show it. Show it, show it, show it.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Trying to tan my cheeks. But this is how I roll. Come on, ladies, it's time to go. We headed to the bar, baby. Don't be nervous. No shoes, no shirt, and I still get service. Watch.
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body.
I work out.
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body.
I work out. When I walk in the spot, this is what I see.
Sexy and I know it.
Aye.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Check it out. Check it out. Wiggle, 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 yeah. Wiggle, 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 yeah. Wiggle, 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 yeah. Wiggle, 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 yeah, yeah. Do the wiggle, man. A little wiggle, man. Yeah. I'm sexy and I know it. Hey. Yeah.